that's enough intro montage. Let's. Hey, strangers, it's me, the stranger that talks to strangers. And today, we're not going to talk to any strangers. We're going to watch my old videos of me talking to strangers, and I thought it would be cool if I told you a little backstory behind some of my most viral videos. So, is this self-serving? I don't know. I'm going to be honest with you. I never knew that TikTok had a website you could log in on the computer. Obviously, it makes sense that they do, but... Okay, I want to talk about this video first because it was the first time I ever posted a video and it also went, I guess, quote unquote, viral. There was this trend going around, I guess the Work Iggy Azalea song, and these nurses were trying to do the trend and they had me download TikTok, and with the app, I recorded it. And they were like, oh, you have to send me that. Because I didn't know how to send things on TikTok, I think I was private. And I thought you had to be public to send something. I went public with it, sent it to them. They're like, oh, thanks. And I looked down at my phone. It's like buzzing a lot. And I look and it says notifications from TikTok. I'm like, what? So I put the phone back in my pocket and I finished the day with the patient. And after work, I look at my phone and the video has 500,000 views. Although I got like no followers from this video, it was the first video I ever posted. I didn't even have a profile picture. I think I was heavily motivated to start making content because of this. While I didn't want to make this kind of content, it did show me that this app has powerful ability to reach a large audience. Growing up, I loved YouTube and I've always wanted to make content. So I was like, okay, I guess I have a chance right now to maybe amplify my voice. Yeah, so okay, let's watch the video. That's it, that's all it was. Is this why it takes 3 hours to leave the hospital? Is this why it took 30 minutes for ice chips? Okay, next video. After I made the infamous Iggy Azalea video, I started making videos like this where I tell patients stories, but because of HIPAA, I couldn't use her name, so I would always use nicknames. This is the first video that I made that I would say actually gained some traction for something I wanted to gain traction. Okay, let's watch it.
My friend just broke up with her boyfriend, and she messaged me and said, I'm scared I'll never find love again. It reminded me of a lesson I learned from a patient a year ago named Sophia.
I was so insecure about my hair because it was going through its growth stage. My whole life, I just had short hair. It was really one of my first times talking in front of the camera. So I just started playing with my hair, pretending that I was going to put it in like this weird bun looking thing. So.
Sophia was an 87-year-old retired pilot that I would check on every few minutes. Every time I'd go in a room, she'd be laughing with her boyfriend, Ron.
That's
true.
I asked
her what her secret was to a long and healthy relationship, and her and Ron started laughing. She said, Ron and I have only been together for 2 years. I've been single for most of my life, she said. Now that wasn't a backstory I was used to hearing, so I had to ask. Sophia, were you ever scared you weren't going to find that one special person? She looked at me and she said, I was never scared I wasn't going to find someone. I was scared I wasn't going to find myself. Sophia passed peacefully a few days later with Ron right next to her side. He told me he had never received a greater gift than her. Now, that's amazing if you find someone.
Again, this is one of my first times really talking to the camera, so you have to excuse how awkward it is.
If you fall in love. But the most important part of life, the main part of life, is to find yourself. Take yourself on dates, learn who you are. Fall in love with yourself. After all, you are the main character.
That main character thing, my friends would not drop it for like a year. They every time they see me, they say, yo, it's the main character, yo, what's up? Oh, this is my first stories from stranger video.
This would you have for someone who's struggling to find happiness?
I always thought you don't look for that, it'll find you. Because when you look in that, you usually make the wrong decisions. You're trying too hard. You know, eventually, if it's supposed to come your way, it will.
Yeah.
That's what I believe. It don't, that's all.
It's beautifully said.
I hope.
Do you follow your own advice?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. If I deserve it, I'll get it. If I don't, I won't.
What's your name?
Joanne.
Nice to meet you, Joanne.
Nice to meet you too, sweetheart.
Yeah, it used to be advice from strangers. And I think a lot of the videos that I do now, it's still considered advice, but I think I like the tag stories from strangers a lot better. I remember how nervous I was to post this video. Now I can go on the street and walk up to people and I don't really feel too weird because I have an excuse. I can say, oh, I'm making a documentary. I'm doing this for a video. Don't worry, I'm not weird. I had this journal that my mom bought me and I thought it'd be really cool to pretend like the journal was something that a stranger was writing in. I don't know, I had this idea.
Excuse me, can I ask you a question? Is there something that you're still trying to prove to yourself?
Yeah, I guess so.
What is that?
I was diagnosed as bipolar when I was at the height of my career. So it just really crushed me and I just stopped doing it. And now I'm like really full speed ahead to like prove to myself that, yeah, you know, you studied this, you should do it, you know?
My rule of thumb for meeting strangers is if they're doing something, I don't talk to them. I don't like to invade their personal space like that. I'm already invading their personal space by asking them a question. But when I was walking by, this woman stopped and she said, "Hey, what do you think of these flowers?" And I said, "Oh, I think they look good." She's like, "Oh yeah, I've been working on them." Like, she was starting a conversation with me. So I was like, okay, I'm just gonna do it. I'm gonna ask her. And I was still really, I still get nervous to ask strangers questions, but especially at this time, I was very nervous to ask questions. She was so welcoming and open that I was like, okay, I'm just gonna try. And she gave a beautiful response.
You shouldn't have been defeated back then.
The garden is sort of a manifestation of that proof to yourself.
Yeah, I'm revisiting something that I probably could have done all along. It's been healthy and good, so you can come back and see if it's like really grown in and looks beautiful.
Of course, yeah. What's your name?
Catherine
Hunter. It's nice to meet you.
I did go back and look, and it is really grown in and beautiful. Catherine did a great job on the garden. Okay, next video. I was walking down this random alley in Pittsburgh, in this little neighborhood that I live in. She stopped me and she's like, really idle conversation, maybe something about the weather. And then I said to myself, okay, listen, this is fate. Like, I have to ask this woman a question. And this is when I realized that this series really had potential to make large impact.
What is the name of your first love, and why did you fall in love with him?
Larry. He was in the grocery store. I kept thinking about, talk about dogs. So I said, well, you got dog food. Okay, I said, what kind of dogs you got? I kept talking. He says, when's your lunch hour? I'll be here to pick you up. That was in February, I think it was. We got married in November.
And how did you know he was the one?
You'll meet somebody, and when you know it, you'll know it. I can't explain the feeling. I just, let's put it this way. There's an old saying, when a man treats his mother nice, then he'll treat his wife nice.
Thank you. What's your name?
D.
Hunter.
Hunter. Okay, I got a grandson named Henry.
She said she has a grandson named Henry, and everyone freaked out. I wonder, one of these comments probably, literally the top comment is, I'm sorry, but Hunter, oh, I got a grandson named Henry. yes. Vera. After I got out of shift, I was walking back from the hospital, and I saw this woman walking her dog, and real pleasant woman, smiling. So I walked up to her, and I asked her a question, and she answered beautifully like this. This happens so often where I meet a stranger, and they're like a poet. I don't understand. If someone asked me these questions, I would freeze up and not know what to say, but for some reason, a lot of these strangers I meet are just street poets, and this is no exception.
What's the name of your first love, and why did you fall in love with
him? Oh, goodness. My first love's name was Vera. I fell in love with her, I think, because of her eyes and her interest in me. And she had a wonderful sense of humor. And we enjoyed doing things together. And I just knew I wanted to be around her. There was just such a warmth about her. We just seemed to be able to listen and hear one another.
What's your name?
Mary.
Hunter. Nice to meet you.
I think the comments that I get in a lot of my videos also really motivate me to keep making videos, because the community that I have, you just say the nicest things. Oh, Clifford. We have to talk about Clifford. A lot of my interviews are typically about 30 minutes long. So when you guys see these 45 second interviews, it's because I distilled it down so it's more consumable for you guys to watch. That pales in comparison to this. This was, I think, 2.5 hours long. My phone was like running out of storage.
You look good. What was the name of your first love, and why did you fall in love with him?
Her name was Holly. I asked her to go with me, and she thought about it. She said, okay. I was thrilled. I couldn't believe it. We went and sat on the back stairs of the steps going down in the basement where nobody was around. She says, no, don't try to French kiss me. I didn't have a clue. What do French do? How do they guess? What's different? And all of a sudden, we kissed, and what do you think she did? Stuck her tongue in my mouth. I'm like, yeah. I remember leaning back and looking down at Holly.
See, it's dark. I didn't even realize.
This is what it was meant to be, in its most beautiful form. My father was a drunk and he was a child abuser. So to find love that had been removed from me by my father, all the heartache and all the abuse and all the sadness, all that stuff just fell off a cliff when I was with Holly. And even now, I'm starting to feel that lightness that I told you about. It's starting to come back.
What's your name?
My name is Clifford.
Hunter, nice to meet you.
Hunter.
And I still stay in contact with Clifford to this day. He messages me every now and again, and he says, how's our video doing? How many views has it got? How many likes does it have? This was an example of me finding a friendship with a stranger, and it was really cool. Okay, so that is all. I have more videos that I'd love to talk about, but I don't want to make this video too long. What did you guys think of this? Do you like whenever I do a behind the scenes of these videos? I have a lot more videos. I think I have like 300, so I can make a few more of these videos if you all like it. Okay, I'm talking too much, I know. Thank you all. Goodbye.